Theon's turn. What is even Theon?
Sum of three terms is 62.
So T1 plus T2 plus T3 is?
62.
I can write it like this or I can write it like?
S3.
S3, correct. And then what else?
Sum of infinity is 62.5.
Nice. Do you remember what's the formula for S3?
A bracket 1 minus r n minus
Now, just curious, why don't you guys write r above n minus 1?
Because it's
in color.
Not in between.
Because this is, it has sum to infinity. It means your ratio must be getting
smaller.
That's why you write like that. Okay, you have two formula, right? It's either r above n minus 1 or 1 minus r above n. I'm choosing this because it has sum to infinity. Sum to infinity means your ratio is getting smaller and smaller. Like, remember, divide by half. That's why I use this, because I know my ratio will be smaller than 1. Right. And then sum to infinity formula, Simi? A over? Yes. Now, up until this point, what do we do, Jeffrey? I have two equations, so substitution or a simultaneous. Shiny, how do you use simultaneous?
I use A plus AR plus AR squared.
Oh, okay. That's going to be quite long, right?
Yeah. Okay. But then after that, you just cancel out.
Then you do another way and you get the answer. Yeah. So I want to know how you do it.
How I do it? I just sub it into.
What do you sub? You sub A, sub R, and sub A. So which one to which one?
I use A. 62.5 minus 62.5.
So you this one lah.
Yeah.
So 62.5 minus 62.5.
But then I think.
Is that what you do? So you sub this into this. But if you do this, isn't that going to be quite complicated? No?
Oh my god.
Then what do you do? Oh, we forgot to sub M. M is?
3.
Then what do you do?
Times like this.
No, I didn't use that.
So how did you get the answer? I did it like A plus AR plus.
Okay, AR. Later I check yours. Can I get the pen first? How do you do it?
What?
How do you simultaneous this two?
Sub A.
Like this?
Oh, it's easier if you make A the subject.
I make A the subject.
You make A the subject. Is this already A as a subject?
I make both A the subject.
Okay, you make both A as a subject.
Yeah.
So this becomes 62 minus 62R.
But I didn't multiply it.
You didn't multiply it.
Yeah, 62. Right,
so this one also, you don't multiply it.
No.
Is that what you did?
Yeah.
Is that what you do?
Yeah.
Okay, so A is actually 62.1 minus R over
1
minus R cubed. So you have this, and then?
Then you simultaneously.
Okay, this will work. Then how you simplify this? So you divide 1 minus R, you divide 1 minus R. So you're left with 62.5 equals to 62 over 1 minus r cubed.
Yeah, I multiply it.
Correct. You multiply 1 minus r cubed. So 62.5 1 minus r cubed equals to 62. And then?
Divide by 62.
Then what do you get? 1 minus r cubed equals to just divide by this.
1 2 4 over 1 2 5.
1 2 4
over 1 2 5.
Over 1 2 5.
Then plus
minus one. -1/(1:5). Am I right?
Yep.
Times -1. And then cube root. So r equals to 1/5. Okay, that's not what they want. Yep, done. Actually, there's another alternative way, which is very easy. Can you see this?
You need to find a.
Oh, you need to find a.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Then we just sub it back, lah. A is actually 62.5 1 minus 1/5. So 62.5 times 4/5. What do you get?
50.
50. Now, actually, there's an easier way if you're just quite vigilant. Can you see this guy? A/(1-r). Can I replace it with this?
Whoa.
A/(1-r) is actually 62.5. So actually, I can straight away 62.5 1 minus r cubed equals to 62. So I straight away jump to this step. Yeah. I jumped to this step already. I skipped so many steps. If you can spot that. If not, then back to your basic simultaneous.